and thank all of you for coming. On November 7th of last year, 185,000 San Diegans voted for Proposition C and managed competition. The ballot arguments in favor stated that it was, quote, a tool for the mayor to get our city back on track, unquote, and that it would make government more accountable to taxpayers. Today we are releasing a major report on managed competition that hopefully will lead the city hall, to redouble its efforts. I cannot stress enough the importance of speed and focus. The city's most recent fiscal forecast shows a structural deficit in the general fund for fiscal year 09-08 of $96.3 million. Between now and fiscal year 2012, the mayor's forecast indicates a cumulative deficit of $375 million. This is on top of cost pressures on enterprise funds such as water and wastewater, which are leading to calls for increases, which are already some of the highest in the nation. Let me put this in perspective. For projected fiscal year 2008-2009, the general fund deficit is more than twice the size of the entire library department. It is more than half the size of the appropriation for the San Diego Fire Department. It is nearly the size of the entire Park and Recreation Department. And that's how bad and how big this deficit is. In other words, if the city doesn't fundamentally rethink how it does business, it cannot close the gap without massive, massive cuts. Moreover, without fundamentally rethinking how the city does business, San Diego will be stuck with a balance sheet that allows for no grand thinking, no aspirations, no important civic efforts, rather than a great city like San Diego will be condemned to a place that might have hopes and dreams, but no resources available to make these dreams and hopes and aspirations a reality. Thus, while managed competition would be an important tool for reform at any time, given the city's fiscal crisis, it's a vital tool. It's something that needs to be used and it needs to be done now. Troubling is that the report the mayor released last week anticipates no savings for managed competition next year. Since the transition, the so-called transition, did not occur until summer of 2009, almost 3 years since the voters spoke. We have to act sooner than that, ladies and gentlemen, and that's why I hope that this report will be encouraging to get the city to take action quicker. Let me highlight for you some of our key findings in the report. The authors found at least 11 non-public safety functions the city does where managed competition has benefited taxpayers in other cities. Second, the authors go on to provide 31 short case studies of several hundred other successful managed competition and privatization efforts involving these activities. Using the fiscal year 07 budget, we calculate that the last year the city spent $800 million carrying out these functions. The report then goes on to estimate potential cost savings. Over 30 years of academic and government research have shown that by fully embracing managed competition, the city could expect savings in the range of 10 to 25%. In fact, the federal government has achieved average savings of 28% for managed competition efforts. Assuming San Diego is run in a similar way to other municipalities, engaging in managed competition in these areas could potentially save taxpayers between $80 million to $200 million. These savings would happen in both the general fund and the enterprise funds like water and wastewater. And this is very important in those departments because we know that they're talking about raising water and wastewater fees even greater than they are today. These potential savings and the deficit the city faces demand that managed competition be taken seriously and that we carry out the voters' mandate. It is also why the mayor and his team should move beyond the usual suspects and consider bold and innovative ways to bring competition and reform to major municipal functions. finally, the report discusses best practices when it comes to managed competition processes and some of the internal systems that the city should be building to make full use of these tools. Let me close by reminding you that the power of managed competition is that it is not a slash and burn process. It contemplates giving city departments time to get ready to compete. Indeed, the city of Charlotte, North Carolina, for example, employees have won more than 80% of the managed competition efforts. But this will take time, and it is critical that the city get it right. We've got to get moving on this, ladies and gentlemen. We hope that the report we are releasing today serves to remind all elected officials that the voters spoke last November, and they are waiting. Thank you.